Now, this is in my living room, so please excuse the modern accoutrements. Try and divorce your eye from those, and I'll talk you through what I have. At Stoke Prior, I'll be on a stage. And at Stroud, I'll be outdoors under a massive tree, which is the ideal environment for this, because the set and props I've put together are supposed to represent a wildwood camp. So basically, we're in her camp, so we've got her fire pit. I have put some sticks there to represent fire. I won't be actually setting fire to anything. Got a couple of seating areas, and I'll talk you through what the various bits and bobs are, but just for now that's an overview. Oh, and then at the back we've got some stuff as well. Now, I will need a trestle table. That's the one thing I don't have for myself, ideally a wooden trestle table. So if I just talk about what's at the back to begin with, the battle horns. I won't be wearing them during the play because they're just far too unwieldy to move about in, but I do think it's really important that they're represented, as this is potentially what motherhood is like when she's like really, really got that battle lust. Like, that is what Athelstan, that's what he's going to meet in battle. Even if we don't see it during the monologue, we know that that's potentially what's going to happen. Then we've got some things that will be brought onto the main area. A dish of water to wash the sword. A bowl of nuts. Now, they're peanuts today, but they will be hazelnuts. But I don't have any hazelnuts today, so there's peanuts. Just brings a bit of movement if I can go back and forth. And you can see I've clad the wig stand there just to hide the metal and plastic. Right, so moving on to this first seating area. We've got the stand for the sword. And I thought, well, she hints that she owns an axe, so where better to put the axe than in the log? Safer there as well. We've got this stool that was kindly made by my dad, and I will say the weapon stand was also made by my dad. I'll just show. It's a forked stick there. So my dad made this stool, and then Crude Apache generously donated a rustic looking bottle and beaker, because my throat is going to get dry, so I'm going to need water. There's a big stick there that will depend on whether I can fit it in the car as to whether that actually appears in the play. The shield, not exactly sure where it will be propped, but it'll be somewhere on the set. At Stroud, might balance it against the trunk of the tree. And then at an opportune moment when she's talking about the Norse, we can turn the shield round, whoops, and show the decoration. I say we, me, I. Another seat here covered in sacking, because it's a bit more, well, it's not modern looking, but it's, I don't know, didn't say Saxon to me. There will not be a cat on the set. She just lives here. So a fire pit. Again, this is something my dad put together for me. I said rustic. It's certainly that. I love it though, because you can just obviously make that so it's just a flat bundle of sticks for transportation. more sticks to represent the fire, a cauldron. So on the day, I'm thinking I'll just go out and pick some dandelion leaves, nettles, edible herbage. We've got a basket of stuff. We've got, well, those are a pair of horns I'll actually wear. So my idea is, these are medium-sized horns. So ideally, they'll be worn in Act 2. And then I've got coming a pair of small horns for Act 1 and a larger pair for Act 3. We got a little felt doll. It began life as a voodoo doll, but I just thought it'd be nice if she had a little poppet, some sort of maybe something she made for her daughter. She's got her little peg family there. We've got a fox skull. She talks about how she killed a fox for the meat and the skin. We've got the spinning equipment, again, kindly provided by my dad, who made the spindle, wool that I gathered from Avebury. We've got a knife from Simon Morgan at Strange Fascination Theatre Company, just in case I need to cut the wool. And teasels, just in case I want to card the wool. We've got a bundle of sticks. And the sticks are nicely, neatly bundled together with some leather cord at the moment. I'm considering that maybe before the play starts, I could have scattered random sticks around either the front of the stage or maybe within the audience area itself, so that I can get some movement in by going and gathering the sticks and bringing them back. Got some antlers there, which, you know, imply either she's been making tools from antlers or they might be like her own sheddings, who knows. So hopefully with all that in place, we've got an entire little camp for her to move around and feel at home in. As I say, just the issue of getting a trestle table at the back. I do have sacks in that basket. I'd rather they stayed in there because they're lifting everything up, but I could use something else in the basket, and then the sacks could be used to disguise a table and just make it look more rustic. So that's where we are. Thank you very much for watching.